Welcome back to another episode of the Arc Switch Survival Guide. Today we are going to teach you how to make gasoline, which is used as fuel for all kinds of things we're going to be building soon. But in order to get gasoline, we need to use hide and oil. And a lot of people don't really know where to get oil on Arc. So we're going to show you some of the more conventional methods where you can get oil, but also some really cool tricks where you can get really easy oil without having to risk going down in the depths of the ocean. But we'll also show you how to do that. So watch the rest of this episode for some great tricks on how to get oil and how to make gasoline on Arc. So for starters, let's answer the very quick question of how to actually make gasoline. So we have a refining forge here, and we are just going to place 5 hide and 6 oil into that refining forge. Make sure there's wood for fuel, and just light that up. And if you wait a couple of minutes, that's going to turn the 6 oil and 5 hide into 5 gasoline. And that should pop up in just a second. So you can put an entire stacks up and just let that keep refining, and you'll end up with lots of gasoline as long as you got a lot of oil and hide in there. So that is actually how you make the gasoline itself, which you're then going to use as fuel for a fabricator, which we are going to make in the next episode, and things like electric generators, which we will make really soon to make an electric grid. So we're going to be using gasoline quite a bit, and we need to make a large supply before we start making a lot of these systems. You can also put stacks of oil and hide in a refining forge along with tons of metal, and it will just keep producing metal ingots alongside your gasoline. So it's just good to keep all of that in there together and just let that keep on running. And that's going to be probably enough fuel for everything that we're going to do in the next episode. So let's talk about where you can actually get the oil that we're using. So by far the easiest and safest way to get your hands on oil is to just kill trilobites that you find on the beaches. Now, trilobites normally kind of hang out in the shallow water, so they're harder to spot. But around morning, they actually start to climb out onto the beaches, and you can just fly all up and down the coast and just kill and harvest all of the trilobites that you can find. And if you use a hatchet, it will get you more oil, where using a pickaxe gets you more silica pearls. And in this video, I'm trying to get silica pearls, so I'm using mostly the pickaxe. But that's a really good, effective way to start stockpiling tons of oil throughout the game. And then by the time you're ready to make gasoline, you'll have a bunch. Now, another method that I like to use is to farm Hesperornis eggs. Now, I've got a couple videos on how to get the trilobites and also how to farm Hesperornis eggs, but if you take a Hesperornis egg and drop it into your cooking pot, you can light it up and it will actually turn into 12 oil per egg, which is really easy, even though it's really hard to actually tame the Hesperornis. But if you get a bunch of those, they're just going to keep farming eggs like that and give you all the oil you need. Now, probably the best way I like to get oil is through dung beetles, and I have not showed you how to do that yet in this series because you have to go into really dangerous caves to get dung beetles on the island. But I'll put a link to my Ragnarok guide. Pardon the barely bad video quality from my old videos, but that will teach you all about dung beetles and how to use them to get oil if you do happen to have the power to go down into some of the caves and actually tame some dung beetles down there. Now, this is a map of the island, and it shows all of the spots where oil can be found just out in the world. And these are all these little black dots all around the island. Now, most of these are found underwater, and you'll need to take a dolphin or some kind of a water creature down to the deep ocean in order to actually get those oil nodes. And we'll show you what those look like in a second. But up here in the northeast side of the map, all around this island, there are lots of oil nodes that are actually up on the surface. So if you head to where the blue obelisk is, and then look at the bottom of the slopes of that mountain that it's above, all of these areas down here are full of oil nodes that are just out on the icebergs, and you can just pick them up without ever going underwater. Now, it's freezing cold, and it's really dangerous out here, but if you can safely get to this area, you can get hundreds and thousands of oil just by grabbing the rocks that are up on the surface. And if you use an ankylosaur, it will get you way more oil per node. So if you can make it up here safely, definitely that's probably going to be your easiest way to get oil and get tons of it. But it is much more dangerous up there. Now, all around the island, no matter where you live, if you can tame a dolphin or any kind of really good, fast sea creature, you can find these black oil nodes, which are basically just a rock with oil streaming up from it. And this is what they look like on land, too. So if you find these, you can actually just mine them with your pickaxe and get tons and tons of oil off the bottom of the ocean. The problem is you have to deal with all the sharks, rays, and other crazy stuff that is just going to kill you and constantly chase after you. So the ocean is no safe place. As soon as you get in the water, there's things trying to kill you. And I haven't even showed you how to tame a dolphin yet, because as soon as you have a tame dolphin, all the sharks come and try to eat him. So you've got to make a dolphin pen and figure out how you're going to protect it. And then actually taming it is also quite difficult. So definitely, I'll put some links in the description for how I did all of these things on Ragnarok if you choose to go that route. But a lot of the first tricks that I taught you for how to get oil are going to be the easiest ways to do that. And it'll save you a lot of heart attacks and trouble with sharks and things like that. So I really hope this guide was helpful for finding out how to get gasoline and oil on Ark. And if you liked it, please drop a like and a comment if you have any questions. I always really appreciate your feedback. And please be sure to subscribe to this channel. We're getting very close to 1,000 subscribers. And we have a 1,000 subscriber challenge going right now, where once we hit 1,000, my wife will actually join me for some cooperative gameplay on Ark as a special guest for this channel. So I promise that will be well worth it and lots of fun. So be sure to subscribe if you haven't already, and we'll see you in the next video. Thanks so much for watching this video from the Ark Survival Guide. If you enjoyed it or found it helpful, please like this video and subscribe to our channel so we can bring you more great guides like this one. Ark is an amazing game, but there is so much to learn before you can really enjoy it. We are dedicated to bringing you high-quality guides, tutorials, and Let's Play videos that are fun, helpful, clean, and suitable for the entire family. There's a tutorial in this series for everything we have done so far in this video. Check out these playlists for more episodes from this series and other guides to help you enjoy your journey on Ark.